Hi there, welcome to Cannabis Table, proudly brought to you by Poppy Weed. At Poppy Weed, we are bridging the gap between cannabis and Africans. And I am Tombra Servo, your host. On today's episode, I shall be telling you of how cannabis is used for terminal colon cancer. Report has it that colorectal cancer is the third leading cause of cancer mortality in the US. The American Cancer Society estimates that this year alone, there will be 106 and of course 180 new cases of colon cancer diagnosed. Aside that, there have been a new study that shows that certain cannabinoids, including CBD, CBDV, CBG, CBGV, and CBL, can eliminate the growth of anther colorectal cancer cells in humans. This study offers a guiding light to those researching cannabinoids for cancer treatment, although they are limited in their scope. As you know, cannabis is effective as a means of managing anxiety and depression. Cannabis induces a feel-good effect and a loss of touch with reality. These effects can be used positively to relieve anxiety and depression. It is a fact that cancer patients often undergo emotional turmoil, especially terminal cancer in particular, which causes anxiety that may result to depression if not checked. So here are a few examples of how cannabis can help a colon cancer patient. Number one is pain. Cannabis may be helpful for the management of cancer-related pain when conventional therapy are ineffective or are causing adverse effects. Secondly, neuropathy. Neuropathy or nerve damage is a feeling of weakness, numbness, tingling, a burning in the hands and feet. It is a common side effect of chemotherapy and other cancer treatments. Now, studies and animals have demonstrated that cannabinoids can be helpful in relieving some of the symptoms of nerve damage. However, small studies involving patients. And number three is nausea and vomiting. Many patients experience nausea and vomiting as a side effect of chemotherapy. Dronabinol and nabilone are synthetic cannabinoids FDA approved for the treatment of chemotherapy-induced nausea and vomiting. And lastly, number four is appetite and weight loss. Now, limited studies have demonstrated that THC stimulates appetite and helps to slow down weight in patients with advanced cancer. However, it was not considered more effective than conventional treatments. Still, several states have approved the use of cannabis for the treatment of cancer-related anorexia, the medical term for loss of appetite, or cachexia. And that has been the package for today. Do not forget to subscribe and click on the notification to get alerted about our new episode. Follow us on any of our social media platforms showing on your screen. And please do not forget to follow us for product reviews, research-based articles. I am Tombra Servo, signing out for today. I'll see you on the next episode. Bye-bye.